hunting is a way of life. If nothing else, it's, you know, a common interest, a commonality there. And it's just, it's ingrained. I can remember we'd go spend the night at the camp house and wake up in the morning and all the parents would be gone and out in the deer stands, and evenings we'd be out there with them. I hope our kids take their kids hunting, who take their kids hunting. My grandpa said, if you find a job you like, you'll never work again. Being able to work with animals and help manage them and conserve them just perpetuates that feeling. Hopefully, I am able to hold on to those little tidbits that are our heritage. In 2015, the sky fell out. They found a positive in a deer breeding facility.
With deer in particular, right now we're worried about chronic wasting disease.
There is no treatment or cure. The only real management technique we have is containment.
Most of our reaction at that time was just wanting for it to not be true.
We have an online web portal called TWIMS, the Texas Wildlife Information Management Service. It's the central database that we use to manage deer breeding in Texas.
We wound up disabling the TWIMS website to prevent any additional release of deer.
All deer breeders were kind of on hold. They couldn't transfer deer for a while we worked on making modifications.
I mean, we were affecting people's livelihoods, shutting them down at that point.
It's only the type of thing that you do if things are really bad.
Our job is to nip it at the bud and find it like a cancer, wall it off, and, you know, not let it spread out.
We were essentially given a deadline that said, look, we've got to get deer breeders moving again. We've got to get commerce going again by deer hunting season. I think it was 57 days. Mike's very proactive and has looked at all aspects of how we use TWIMS and always attempts to identify areas where we could have some improvements. And one of those areas that he identified was that we need a tool to look at essentially how do facilities communicate with one another.
We built in a whole messaging kind of system for the deer breeders to try to help them accept or decline a transfer.
That became all consuming.
The programmers would fix code at night, and then we'd come back in the next morning, we'd test again, and we just had a cycle going day after day after day.
Without their effort, the whole project would have been set up to fail.
As a team, I think we had a bunch of different skills that came together and helped us get the project done on time.
Hopefully we've discovered CWD early enough that we might even be able to potentially eradicate it still at this point, that this is not something that we'll have to worry about in the future.
CWD poses a significant risk to one of the most treasured natural resources of our state. Our program is helping to mitigate that risk.
Some of the best people in the agency are on this project, and so it's an honor to be named amongst them. Protecting a way of life, protecting the enjoyment of it. The biggest relaxations I get is to be able to come out here and hunt. That is why we do what we do, is in the name of protecting that heritage.